because the economy has collapsed. And I don't need to give you too many examples. I think you, all of you know. So that did not happen in Sri Lanka because there was the steps taken to ensure that the overall economic conditions were benign even after the war was over. So we prepared for it. We knew exactly what to do in the north. We knew exactly what to do with the other areas to see that the overall development focus is not in any way reduced in its intensity. And we were also not deterred or distracted or discouraged by various disruptive elements. There were many. It would have been very easy for us to get discouraged. It would have been very easy for us to say, look, this is far too much for us to handle. But it did not happen, and the opposite happened, and this is the story. So upon reflection, I think there are several lessons that I would like to share with you. I will end with those lessons, which I think are useful for us to reflect on, because finally, after defeating terrorism in the nation building, we had 2 years of hard work, which we believe has been successful, and we need to share with the rest of the world what those lessons are. Lesson one is that regular improvements in infrastructure and other aspects of life is vital. People must see that it has changed them. People must see that the conditions have changed from what they experienced during the warlike situation. If they don't see that, then what's the use, they will say. So we had to ensure that restoration of all facilities was done very, very quickly. And that was one of the most important factors in our journey of nation building. Lesson two, we had to maintain a close dialogue with the local communities. Sometimes some people from across the world think that our dialogue should be with people 8,000 miles away or 12,000 miles away. No, we need to have dialogue with the people on the ground, the local communities. They sometimes say, you didn't consult a person in Canada, or we did not consult somebody else in New Zealand. Maybe somebody should do that there. But in order to nation building to take place successfully, you need to talk to the people who are affected, who are there on the ground. Ask them, the farmer, the fisherman, the student, the teacher, the university lecturer, ask him what he wants. Ask him what his problems are. Ask him how do we tackle that. And we had enormous number of meetings of that nature. I think the GA will probably endorse that. She was there at many of those meetings. She has been a wonderful resource. She has been also able to ensure that this dialogue takes place in that right fashion. And this was very important. So not only were the people consulted, all who had stakes in ensuring that this change takes place were consulted, and that's the dialogue that we had to have. Lesson two. Lesson three, have simple procedures and clear objectives that are easy to understand, not complex situations. So we ensured that everything that we do had a simple question and answer, and we were able to deliver it on that basis. And some decisions were allowed to be taken at the local level. It was not to be referred to Colombo to make a decision. So people on the ground were able to take the decision, so that people who were involved in talking to these decision makers had a very easy passage. Lesson four, encourage the ground level military personnel to work closely with the civilians. Every time when I go, I have seen people of the area inviting the military personnel for their functions. And not because that they want them to be there in any other need other than the friendship. I think you have been successful in building up that close relationship because they invite you because I think they like you. And many, I can see from the body language that there has been that partnership that has been developed, which is an extraordinary transformation when you realize that just a few years ago that there has been such a lot of tension between the two parties. So some of the success stories are necessary to be spoken of as well. Lesson five, have regular and effective monitoring mechanism. If you do something and forget about it, it doesn't work. You need to constantly monitor, address the issues and problems urgently, and ensure that whatever problems are there are addressed urgently. Six, I've already spoken about it, implement fast-track livelihood generating measures. Many times, the grouse against banks is that they give the money at the time that you don't need it. When the farmer is ready to cultivate, he must have the support to buy the fertilizer, to support to buy the seeds. That is the time that he needs the money, not at the time that he is ready to harvest. So we ensured that fast-track livelihood generating methods, measures are implemented fast and on the ground. And some people say, I want to just buy 6 cows. I want a tractor. I want a hand tractor. So those were supported on the ground all the time. Last lesson that I would like to talk to you about is think short-term as well as long-term. Many people like to see that happening. And sometimes stakeholders must be encouraged not only be looking at the profit motivation in the short term, but also think of the long-term benefits that you're going to generate. If you have 1 million people in the north who are empowered, who have money in their hands, look at what it does to your markets. Your markets will have another additional 1 million who will be able to buy your goods. So we were able to transform that message. And I believe many of the local companies appreciated that, and they work towards that to ensure that they become part and parcel of the long-term plan that we needed to put in place. So, my dear friends, Commander of the Army, the Secretary to the President, Sri Lanka is an extraordinary case study. We are happy to share that with you. Many outcomes that were considered impossible were realized. And what is important, it was not just accidental. It didn't just happen. It happened because there were serious interventions that were carefully thought through, and we implemented those in the face of incredulous challenges. But we like to believe that this is only the beginning of that long journey. We know that there are huge benefits that Sri Lanka will be able to achieve and also enjoy as a result of this magnificent concept of defeating terrorism is concerned. And we must not in any way allow that victory to be robbed or to be disturbed by any other factor. So we have to be vigilant, we got to be open, we have to be talking about it, we need to share these thoughts with you so that people in the world will know how it was achieved. We still like to think that our mission of nation building is not fully accomplished. We have reached a satisfactory level of working progress, no doubt, but much more needs to be done. But the successes so far, I must say, gives us the confidence to face the future. So let us identify the new opportunities as well and continue to deliver results and value. Thank you very much.